Hello again, everybody. I'm Teacher Kaye, and today I'm going to talk about teletherapy. Tele what? I'll tell you all about it. Let's get talking. Hello again, it's another Wednesday, and thank you to everyone who have continued to support the playlist. And I'm still getting such great feedback, but I would love to hear from you more. Know that you can tag me on Instagram at TeacherKTalks, and you can share with me the stories or posts that you have of the way that you have tried the tips or the way that your children have responded to the tips and techniques that I've shared. I would love to see your success stories at home and see you guys get talking. Today, I'm not going to talk about a specific tip or technique, but I'm going to introduce an option for families that need the services of a speech-language pathologist amidst this pandemic that we are still in. So this option is teletherapy. It is under the branch of telepractice, of telehealth. It is for people who need health or allied health services, and in this specific case, speech-language pathologists, but have no access to it right now because a lot of clinics and centers have not reopened. Teletherapy is a relatively young method of delivering services in the field of speech pathology. Originally, this was developed to address the needs of those who have limited to no access to said services. Perhaps for geographical reasons, they are too far from anyone who offers the services, or other concerns like mobility of the client. The demographic of the people who have limited access have grown exponentially because of this lockdown. Now, so many people just simply don't have that access that they used to. And now practitioners of speech pathology are trying our best to find ways to keep delivering the services despite all the limitations. Simply put, teletherapy is just an online means of doing speech therapy as opposed to in-person consultations or in-person therapy or intervention. Because if you can't see them in person, you have to find ways. In the past, these have been tried purely on phone calls, but with today's technology, there are so many ways by which we can improve these services through online resources. There have been a few scientific studies regarding teletherapy. How effective is it? How efficient is it in delivering what needs to be delivered by the professionals? In the few studies that I've read, all of them have reported little to no significant differences in in-person and teletherapy provided assessment and intervention practices, provided, of course, that everything is well planned by the therapist and coordinated by the parents. Let's make it even simpler. Should you consider teletherapy? Is teletherapy for you? Are you a good fit for teletherapy? I'm going to ask you a few questions, and if you answer yes to them, teletherapy is definitely worth a shot. Do you and your child need the services of a speech-language pathologist during this lockdown? Do you have a device that can connect you online through the internet with a speech-language pathologist? Will you or any other household member be available for at least 1 hour to hold sessions with your child? Then teletherapy might be for you. Here are some of the things you should consider when thinking about teletherapy. You will need a gadget or a device such as a computer, a laptop, a tablet, or a phone. Anything that you can use to video call with a speech-language pathologist. Why is that? Because we will need to coordinate how we're going to hold the session. You may need some other materials for some of the activities that the therapist will prepare, such as paper, pen, crayons. In other cases, the use of your furniture, are they available? Your children's own toys, your cooking materials, your bathroom items, and the list goes on. If you answered no to many of those questions, it's okay. It just means teletherapy is not the right fit for you. But there are still other options, like you could consult with your therapist if a home program could be prepared for you. A home program is a list of goals and activities for a short amount of time will be given to you in a chunk for you to execute or to try out with your child. They will be customized especially for your child's goals and needs. If a home program doesn't sound like a good fit for you either, this is what this Teacher K Talks playlist is all about. I'm teaching you the techniques and tips that you can try slowly at your own time, at your own pace with your child. There are lots and lots of ways for your child to improve or increase their set of skills. Don't forget to talk about availability or scheduling. It's so important. Just like in-person sessions, therapy is most beneficial when done regularly. In the same way, if you dedicate the same amount of time regularly to commit to the program that the speech therapist suggests, it would be the best for your child. For those who have an urgent need for their child to be assessed, you don't exactly know if your child needs speech therapy yet, you may also ask your SLP if an assessment can be administered with your child. Just some last minute notes and recommendations. Please don't expect the therapist to be able to do what they can do in in-person sessions. So in this case, someone in your household needs to be the facilitator, while the SLP will explain to you what needs to be done and will prepare all the materials needed, you will have to make sure your child can execute that from your end. So please feel free to discuss everything with your SLP beforehand regarding your child's goals, needs, your situation at home, their attention span, their behavior, the schedule that you're available, the materials that are available to you at home, the environment, how distracting or conducive is it for the session, how you can modify the environment, and of course, your own commitment to ensuring that the teletherapy goes as best as it could. So if I were to explain how a teletherapy session would go, it would be logging on at a scheduled time, both the therapist and the household member or caregiver. The therapist explaining what the goals are for today, what activities and materials will be needed, and then the actual therapy proper. During the therapy proper, a caregiver or household member needs to be overseeing everything that the child is doing. After that, there'll probably be a short feedback session and then you're done. So just take note that children's attentions are much shorter with on-screen therapy. So therapy sessions may not be as long as they were during in-person therapy sessions. Most importantly, parents, families, therapy does not end in therapy. Therapy needs to thrive at home. Your child spends 98% of the time with your household members in your homes. So whatever needs to be done, needs to be done there. A speech language pathologist will guide you through best practices that you can do with your child. This is a good opportunity to learn what is it exactly that your therapists are trying to teach your children, how they are trying to teach it, and make that your own. So you can do this, mommies, daddies, lolas, lolos, and everyone around the child who only want the best. For those of you who already have a regular speech therapist who is working with your child, it would be best to ask them if they're available for teletherapy sessions as well. For those of you who don't have a dedicated speech therapist yet and want to get your child assessed, I suggest that you look for a teletherapist that is also geographically closest to you. So you can search that online for centers that are near your location. I suggest this so that when you do get things going and you start to have access to in-person therapy, you can continue that progress with the same person. So I hope this short video helps you decide whether or not you want to give it a shot, to give teletherapy a chance, and if not, know that there are other options available for you as well. But the best is still in-person consultations with your speech-language pathologist. So this is Teacher Kaye signing out. Don't forget to like and subscribe and share this to your friends who may need it. And happy talking!